Hello there, everyone. This is Iron Mark 3, and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, where I am just pondering my many sins, effectively. Or something to that effect, I don't really know. Anyway, yeah, let's dismantle all that. I'll just, as I normally do when I start recording a session, I was just thinking, pausing to think a little bit and see what I might want to try and do and how to get started. And I think I'm going to get started with still getting some light in place, though sadly these... Yeah, not the best place for them. It's a really small place to be, but, you know, can't have everything, can you? From there, so that's those three places will be lit up. And then there's that one up there, too. I'm deleting those wires there. Yeah, that looks okay. Okay, just pulling this down here. Now then, I'll just run the wire down here so that I have got a unified secondary circuit across here, which can provide me with lighting like that. Yep. So that's going to help. And then, well, thing is, I'm saving that battery there that I had there, and it's still connected to this wheel and this one. So this battery will continue to be the punching bag, as someone mentioned. Yeah. It just looks so punchable, doesn't it? Made of heavy metal and crackling with electricity. I'd want to hit something like that, definitely. But, yeah, I'm going to keep working on this. So, a light there. Okay, so that reaches to that. Let's put a light in here. And a light in here. And a light in here. So that'll be a bunch more lights going in. And connect those to the same grid as well, since I've got this entire section cut off basically from the rest of it. So that'll bring lights to a portion of my base when they get around to doing that. But yeah, another thing I really do need actually is more power storage. That is a definite issue. And I need to be more diligent about actually refilling my power storage too. What's that, chlorine? Sure. Let's just get the batteries connected like this. So this is going to be a major source of heat, yes. But it's sort of sectioned off in an area, so that's okay. And I'm also going to turn these generators up so they won't... They'll actually respond more rapidly, like, let's set them to 40%. I wish there was a way to mass set these, but there isn't. Because, honestly, leaving it at 20% with my power reserves like that are not enough to keep the base running throughout the night, and so oxygen production stops during the night and things like that, so it's not great. It's once again a case of trying to get my base a bit more optimized. Food shortage. What? And that one's on its own separate circuit now, so make sure the batteries are at least half charged. Food shortage, 10,000 calories available. I think it was that recent pressure drop that's caused a problem. Oh dear, okay. Yeah, definitely that recent pressure drop. And then I'll just priority 9 all of this, get it built immediately. Because I can. Because I can, because I want to try and make sure that all this stuff actually gets done. And also clear that one, because that's nowhere. And that one can stay there. Right. Come on, peoples, you can do all this stuff, no problems. Can't you? Of course, it doesn't help that I've got all these extra things in circuit now, so my power drains more rapidly. But I need to get all over this power situation. Especially without any coal to mine out. Because I know there's food shortages, I know there's coal going on. And things like that. Wasn't there some more coal somewhere else? There's coal there. There's a little bit there. Someone's suffocating. What? Oh, that's because of the low pressure. Yeah. I'm just glad that these things stop working when they overpressurize, and these things stop working whenever there's a vacuum, because that's causing fluctuations in the power demand, as far as I can tell. And suddenly it all shuts down again as soon as I go to check. So hooray for that. Now, next comment was that my base will do a lot better if everyone can... If I can get my base cleaned up, then everyone will do better and things like that. Then, yes, that is absolutely true. But the thing is, we've got a cause and effect situation going on here. Also, three people lashing out, so three things are about to get busted up. That battery's getting busted up. Oh, that's been busted up. What's the third thing? It's probably going to be a power wheel, isn't it? Repair that one. Yep. Come on, third thing. Where is it? I know there's supposed to be a third thing getting broken. Strange. It said three people lashing out, but I only see two things broken. Oh, food. Food! Give me food. Yeah, I drained so much power. Let's actually, for once, prioritise our power generators. And take out the people that are worst at it, and just put the best people on it. Because I want the charging to go more effectively. And now that the lights are in place, priority 9 all this. So I get an adequate power reserve built up. Yep, there's the third one. Goodbye, power wheel, but it's on the secondary circuit, so that's okay. The circuit that's powering all of these pretty lights, showing people just how bad this base really is. And yeah, there you go, someone else vomiting. As I said, it's a cause and effect situation. I can get the base cleaned up, yes, but I can't finish doing that because all of my poor little duplicants are so stressed out about how the base is, that they just, they can't help it. They don't start to calm down, and they immediately break things again because everything is so bad. I mean, look, another person's just lashing out right now, so it's, it happens extremely regular. So, I might as well keep on bullying them, to be quite honest. Now, what's built up over here, then? Let's check. How many people do I have? 11. I have capacity of 6. So, since I can't keep the base cleaned up consistently in one go, and, oh jeez, that's a pressure drop going on again. Algae, I need some algae. Here, algae, I'm looking in these zones, it's probably the best bet to find some. Oh, there's some there. There's some down there, and some there. That's a big patch down there. Don't have a good spot to dig out to that, unless I go this way. And there's a huge patch down there, but it's mostly bordering on some gases and things I'd rather not have in the area, so that is also something. No easy options for algae, as far as immediate access is concerned. I think... maybe I should just go for this, and then if I can route back that hydrogen as well. There's a fair bit of hydrogen there, so pumping it into my hydrogen system is probably going to be a good idea. And then the chlorine is just... bleh, chlorine. I don't have any morbs to take care of that. Since, as I mentioned last time, morbs, they can take in chlorine while they're emitting CO2, so they can clean up chlorine, I think. Not entirely too sure about that, to be quite honest with you. Okay, right, I know what I'm doing. Famous last words. Okay. Actually, I'm going to red alert, get everyone out of bed and just do stuff. Now then, let's see. I'm going to put in an airlock, because I don't really want to expand... I can't properly supply where I am right now, so... I'm going to do it like this. Yeah, I'm already getting a load of notices. 1, 2, 1. a set like that, and a set like that. That too. Right, as I was saying, it's cyclic. Chicken egg situation, I guess you could say. That's probably a better way to describe it. And yeah, that there goes that oxygen cycle again. Oh, yep, that battery's gone too. Yep. Because as you can see, they're all so high stress, it just keeps on cycling over and over and over. So I've tried to clean up the base like a couple of times before to treat it that way. And it's been a case of As soon as it's partway done, someone will vomit in an area which has already been cleaned. So then suddenly all the progress is undone again. Damn it! Okay, that's going to help. Where the heck did? Well, okay, right. That was not intentional. I must stress that. That was not intentional. I've got Suki, Ralph, and Elva. Down to 8 people. Yay! 8 people. My artist is still here. My cooks are still here. Oh, I lost a couple of my longer residents because my power generation abilities have dropped a little bit. Right, okay. And that's filled up my existing grave slots, actually. Which sucks. That sucks a lot. This is still a really bad arrangement. Well, that said, I did find some coal from somewhere, so that's working, but I wasn't wanting to kill people off. I must stress that, okay? Okay? I was not trying to kill people off, and then I just kind of did, so I just wanted them to work through the night, but and they did. They've got a few bits and pieces done. Look, here comes the guy who's starting to charge up that particular wand, which is feeding all those lights. Yeah, this is exactly what the duplicates want to see, isn't it? And someone's flashing out again. Probably going to hit that battery. They always go for the battery. Yep, there they go. I love that little battery. Because everyone just goes and kills it every chance they get. Okay, manual locks. Actually, let's go for the mechanized locks. Even without power, they are faster than regular locks. Then I want some plumbing down here. I want to grab a gas pump. Yep. I want a couple of gas vents. One there. And, actually, I need a gas filter. Like, one there and one there. Yeah, twin filters, sadly. That's going to be another drain on power, isn't it? Then gas piping is going to be like... Well, it's going to be one pipe there. That's going to deal with the chlorine. Right? That's going to feed straight into that one. Wait, that's not right. Whoops. Don't worry, I'm a trained engineer. I know exactly what I'm doing, and that's backwards. Whoops, again. I do that more often than you'd think, to be honest. Okay. And I'm on the wrong tab. Right, there we go. I swear, I am such a goof sometimes. Like how I just accidentally killed 3 people when I was just a moment of inattention. That needs to go like that. Actually, I should put it right there. Yep, I just heard the portal go, but I'm struggling for keeping things going as it is, so that's fine. Okay, that vents the chlorine back out. Rest will go onwards. This will vent the hydrogen out, and then that will just vent everything else straight into here. So, this one will run straight up here, like that, and plug straight into that. So yeah, hydrogen. I was thinking about just pumping the hydrogen straight into here, but it's better that I just hit it straight into the generator itself, because there is that pressure valve after all, which will make sure that the thing doesn't get swamped with it. So that's the thing. Okay. The power storage is coming together nicely. Anyway, yeah, back to what I was saying before I accidentally killed a sizable portion of my remaining people. The problem is that I can't just randomly clean the base up, because everyone just gets sick again, and then it's I just have them chasing their own tails effectively the entire time. So what I think I'm going to do is this. Yes, thank you. I kind of want that thing to stay online. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm actually going to... Yep, there goes one of the power wheels too. And there goes another power wheel. Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use priority override and red alert to force people to de-stress. But before I do, I am going to have enough cots, sorry, enough massage tables that they will all do it at once. If I can get the stress down, then when they all hit zero, then they can go clean up the base. Because then they won't be vomiting and getting more stressed and getting immediately vomiting all over the place once more. They'll just go mop it all up. So that is the plan, basically. And yep, a bigger power reserve is better. And the generators are struggling to keep all that up, but the coal generator just tapped out. That's obsidian. Right. Oh yeah. Wait, there was another comment that I need to actually address. That is probably actually a pretty urgent one, and it's what getting towards 20 minutes in. Anyway, let's have a check. Right. The comment was that the doors and walls of my hydrogen generator storage were going to break. I'm just checking my water storage as well, because that's more likely to happen there, but nope, all that's intact. Right, storage, hydrogen, walls are all just fine, and the doors are all just fine as well. Yeah, thank you for the concern, but there is actually no sign at all of anything breaking here. I'm guessing you're thinking of these cracked symbols on the doors here, aren't you? That's because in one of the recent updates, there was a new bug came in. It's this one here. It's, look, buried objects. Buried objects and buried objects. Now, if I put it here, the thing is that the door actually has something behind it. As in, it has an item positioned behind it. And so it thinks, oh, this tile has a buried object behind it. I better put the cracks on it. But the thing is, the door is actually at full health. Like, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. It's a bug, and the first time the door opens and closes, it'll refresh itself properly, and then that graphic will disappear. It's a bug that occurs just on loading. So it's a visual bug only. There's not actually wrong with the door, or anything wrong with the doors themselves. So yeah, that's what's happening there. Flashing out again. I'm still trying to fix the darn stuff from last time. Actually, I better get everyone onto building now. I don't think I lost a builder, but better just make sure. So, yeah. Thanks for the concern. Nothing wrong with my storage section here, except for how badly I built it. That's the only thing wrong with it. Right. Okay, so if I can get this section done, then I can start de-stressing everyone. But the thing is, I need that algae generator up there. So, ooh, food. Go get food. Go get food. That's stifled and overheated. That's because the duplicants have been at it again in there. So, yep, as you can see, that's the problem with these. The air temperature is absolutely fine. Air pressure is absolutely fine. But they're in all of this... contaminated water here, which is too hot, and then it's immediately overriding the air temperature and all that. So that is So that needs to be mopped out because it's just... Yeah, look, it's doing that up there as well. And there's, the air up there is a little bit warmer, but it's still all just fine. It's the water that's doing it. So it's the water that's stopping my farming efforts, and it's being caused again by all this vomiting that's going on. Oh. And apparently I buried one of my coal generators. I don't know. Someday I will get this base fixed, but I don't think it's going to be today. That power storage is actually about up. And then, actually, I thought on efficiency, I would actually be better if I moved this biodistiller back into the base and then did it that way, because and then pumped the contaminated oxygen back out in an air pump. Because then, well, they have to make two trips out here every time they want to use this thing. One trip to get the to get the slime, and then another trip out to grab the algae. If I move the biodistiller back into the base, then it'd be a case of they'd only have to go out and grab the slime, then come straight back into the base, and they wouldn't have to go very far for the algae trip. So yeah, that's what's broken this time. Well, someone's breaking the battery again. Not surprised there at all. That's operational. Right. Coal generator's active. Check. Yep, there goes the battery. Fix that. Okay. Yeah. Oh, that wheel's out. Oh. It was that thing being broken again. Okay. Now then, yep, all of these batteries are now operational. That is good. So they can keep the base charged up. Next stage in my grand master plan is this section. Come on, people, do it. Yes, I know there's 8 people stressed. I'm well aware, thank you, game. There's no way to remove the warnings from up here. Though that's the warnings are kind of important, so, you know. Contaminated water levels are dropping. Water is slowly rising and then going straight into the systems. So, yeah. Let's get my last poor duplicant laid to rest. Goodbye, Ruby. You gave it your best. And it was my mismanagement that got you killed. As with the case of so many others. No, sorry guys, I don't feel like letting you sleep. Do your work, please. This time I will watch out and make absolutely darn sure. About the construction location? Oh. I'm going to make darn sure that no one dies this time. I've lost 3 people this video. I'm back on track for losing 1 every 4 episodes. Harold is suffocating a bit. You're dropping a bit low now. Okay, off you go. Go breathe. Right. Got a fair portion of that built. That's good. I've got that ticking over, so that's good. I'm okay for food. That's good. Right. Who's suffocating now? It is Hideki, and you're not anymore. Okay, you are the last one. Red alert! Come on, back to it, people. Mush, mush, do it. And actually fix that too, while you're at it, please. And that battery again. Poor battery. It's suffering so long, that battery, but it's needed right now. I've said it before, I'll say it again. The only reason it's still there is because... everyone kills it whenever they get stressed. It's their priority target for assassination, so, you know. Keep an eye on Sudeki. Yep, you're fine. You're all fine. Sudeki. Okay, go breathe. Go. Mush. Whew. Yep, that's okay. There we go. Okay, and yeah, as you can see, this is what I just said. The mopping jobs have all been cleared. They've been in here, they've mopped it all. And then it's already full of vomit and whatever. Yeah, it's just vomit, because they have got functioning lavatories after all. So yeah, it's just full of vomit again, and it's all overheating again. So that's the problem. So who's suffocating now? It's Ellie. Yep, you're fine, Ellie. Come on, suck in that putrid air. Suck it all in. You could do it. And that was it. Okay, you're the last one suffocating. So, red alert. Get it finished. And actually, while I'm at it, mop. And mop. Because you saw me do those mop jobs like barely a couple of minutes ago, and it's already... they've already gone and done it all again. So, yeah. I've got to solve that before I can make any real progress on the rest of it. And that's just the way the space is. So who's suffocating first? It is Viola. Right. Oh, that, and that power wheel is down. I think I have too many lights on here for one. Yep, see? There they go. And Harold is up, is suffocating quite a lot. And okay, sure, fine. I'll ease up. As soon as suffocating goes away, I will... Marie, and go. Do it. Work. Mush. Crack that whip. Thing is, mopping takes priority over everything else, so you know. And something's been broken. Oh, it's that battery again. Good little decoy battery. If I could give batteries a cookie, I would. Everyone's fine. Suffocating. Viola, you are the first one. How low are you going to go? Oh, wait, that's all done. Everyone off to cool off. Off you go. Right. Okay. Stage two. Priority down those. Do I have any coal reserves to tap? Because that will be really helpful for this next stage. There was some I saw, wasn't there? Coal. Where are you, coal? Come on, coal. And I don't mean coal from Gears of War. No, I just mean coal, regular old coal. Flipping coal. Coal train. Yeah. Where was that coal that I saw earlier? Wasn't it down here somewhere? I've lost it. Yeah. I've lost it. I know there was some coal, and I've lost it. Yay. I mean, I keep looking at it, and it's obsidian rather than coal. Oh, there's a little bit there. Not an easy reach. Wasn't there some down here? Oh, there's a bit right there. And an algae terrarium. Okay, let's place that. Dig that one. Priority 9 those two. Right. Yeah, I'm abusing the priority system again because I need the things. Don't have easy access anymore, do I? There's a little bit there, actually. So let's go ahead and get that. That's going to destabilize one of my batteries a bit, but that's okay. Yes. Right. Is there any down here? There is a little bit down there, actually. So, again, priority 9. Grab that. Okay, right. Almost ready. And last but not least, set everyone to dig. So they can all go and grab that as soon as I hit red alert. Do it! Do the things! Get those tiles replaced. Get that coal mined. I command you all. Someone is suffocating. Who is it? It is Marie. Okay. You win the prize this time, Marie. And I can't... I'm struggling to see the bar. Okay, red alert off so you can breathe. Go, go, go. Coal generator is active and pumping. Excellent. Okay. I have coal. I have a lot of coal lying around. And that means I can get the coal generator firing on all cylinders, pretty much. Actually, let's enable that one as well. And prioritize 9 that one. And priority 9 that storage, so get they get all the coal up there. Okay, switching the base over to coal power. Come on, coal train, jump on that treadmill and power my entire base. I know you're up for it. A man of your stamina can do anything. Woo, woo, baby. As he would say. That warp level's getting a bit low. But, with that sorted out, actually, is everyone on deliver? Yeah, everyone's on deliver. That should all be... No, red alert. Keep going. Do the things. You can do this. Come on. You're grabbing all that. Okay, we've got some diggers running off down the far end of the world. Oh, no, what are they grabbing? They're grabbing slime. Oh, okay, they're grabbing the slime up. Transferring it to a storage somewhere. Okay. Who's suffocating? It's Marie again! Hooray! Okay. Add it a little bit longer, a little bit longer, and release. The batteries are only partly charged. That's why I had that enabled, the other coal generator, to fire up, so that that could actually be done. But yes. Sadly, that is all the time for this particular episode, so... I'm going to have to call it there before I do that, but the groundwork has now been laid. I have got my base stocked up with a supply of coal to top things off. I've got an expanded power storage so that they won't be called back to the manual generators as much while the coal generators can hold on. They can't hold on long, but they don't have to be frank. Because if with the power storage and generators combined, the base should be able to hold up, kind of. But next episode, I'm going to red alert and prioritize these and de-stress everyone at once. Next episode, I am going to crack this problem at its heart. And then I can clean the base up and they won't fill it with vomit again for a while. So yeah, that's the hope anyway. So, this has been Iron Mark 3. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show, and thank you for sticking with me with this base that I refuse to just let slip quietly into the night. I'll see you all some other time. Catch you later.